And welcome to the latest edition of the Student Diaries. So this time we have another three students from the current class, which will be taking the discussion ahead. So, the objective of the session is to connect you to these students where they share their experiences of the program with you and, tell you about their program experience, how they decided to join, what were the fears in their mind when they were, speculating to join the program. So the format of the session today is, I'll quickly introduce all the three panelists to you, and then they'll take up the introduction of themselves one by one. And after that, I'll ask a few common questions that we receive as a part of admissions. So, all of them will answer that. And post that, I'll open it up for Q&A. If you have any specific questions you want to ask to these students, you can put it up in the Q&A box. I'll pick it up and ask them to the panelists today. So I hope that's okay with all of you, Mandar, Subbu, and Anuj. I hope that's okay.
Yes. Okay, start.
Yeah, fine.
So we have Mandar Kulkarni here, who is the Assistant General Manager at TAFE, which is Tractors and Farm Equipments Limited. And he is the PGP Max student of the April batch, right, Mandar?
Yes.
And we have Subramaniam Vasudevan, who is the General Manager, Sales and Marketing at HSIL Limited. And he is the current PGP Max student of the August cohort. So in 2020, we had two batches. One was the April and one was the August. So that's why, two different batches are naming. And then we have Anuj, who has joined us now. Anuj is the Director and Head of Service Management at SunGard Availability Service. And he is Mandar's classmate from the April batch of PGP Max. So I welcome all of you today here for the discussion and thank you for joining us. So, over to you, Mandar, to start with your introduction.
Yeah, thank you. And hello, everyone. First of all, thank you, Smriti, for this introduction and for organizing this discussion, because it always feels good to connect with all the current ISBNs and aspiring ISBNs. And I'm sure, in fact, when we were planning to join, there were many doubts, even we were having many confusions we were having. We were also seeking for advices from our alumni as alums and the seniors and the professors also and ISB staff. And that's the reason why we could take this decision, because we got good inputs from everyone. And I'm sure today's discussion will try our best to help the aspiring ISBNs. And coming back to my introduction, I'm shared by Smriti, I'm part of a company called TAFE Limited. I'm part of a sales and marketing team. And this company is, we are global number three tractor manufacturer. And I'm associated with this company for last 7 years now. And prior to this, I was with Tata, Ford, and Mahindra. And I worked in various roles like sales planning, sales strategy, and business analysis. And currently, I'm based out of Jodhpur. And I take care of Western Rajasthan for sales in the sales and marketing division. And thanks to PGP Max, which we'll certainly discuss in the discussion today, that things have really changed after joining PGP Max. And we'll come to know through the discussion that how it is going to help each one of you, if you plan to join this particular course. And I will certainly share the best of examples, which will definitely help you all in taking this big decision, which certainly is a life-changing decision and has been a life-changing decision for me. Thank you. Thank you, Smriti.
Thank you, Mandar. Subbu, over to you now.
Yeah, thanks, Smriti. Thanks for the introduction and welcome to all the participants and good evening to Mandar and Anuj. Actually, I am part of HSIL Limited, which is an Indian conglomerate. I think most of you would be aware of Hindwear, which is a big sanitary brand. So it's part of that group. And we have different divisions. So I am part of the packaging products division, where we have products for rigid packaging, which goes as a primary packaging into many of the industries like pharma, liquor, FMCG, and many other industries like agro, chemicals. So we supply all primary packaging to multiple industries. So I've been in sales and marketing for last 18 years and with this organization for last 2.5 years. And prior to this, I was with multiple paint companies. I was with AkzoNobel. I was with Asian Paints. Then I was with Sherwin-Williams. So I was with multiple paint companies and now into packaging products division. And I joined ISB in 2019, August cohort. So it is definitely the decision was a big turning point in my career because I had to expand my horizon of thinking. So in that way, this was one of the decision which I took and also to get into the mode of continuous learning. So that is another key aspect of taking this decision. And I would be happy to answer any questions coming from any of you, the participant, and looking forward to have engaging discussion. Thank you.
Thank you, Subbu. Thank you for a lovely introduction. Anuj, if you could share your introduction.
Yeah. Hey, everyone. I think I'll try to go and keep myself brief. First of all, great to go and have you guys start the first step in the right direction on the learning path, right? And I'm pretty sure that this is just the first step because once you're in ISB, there's going to be lots of learning and a lot of nights where you will not be able to go and sleep. I can promise you that, along with a life-changing experience that you'll go ahead and have in the course, and the fact that you'll make great network of colleagues who come from different industry and who will go ahead and help you learn, not just about what you do and how you can do it better, but what everybody else is doing and how. That can enable you to even, welcome to that first step. And I look forward to going ahead and interacting with you. Personally speaking, I have over 20 years of experience into IT and ITES side. I'm heading a function called service management, which is essentially service delivery within my organization. We are globally based. Our organization is headquarters into North America, into IT infrastructure, primarily into co-location cloud and recovery business. Essentially my team is responsible for the whole delivery of that service. So I look forward to the interaction. Thank you, Smriti, for inviting us to interact with the team.
Thank you, Anuj. Thank you for the introduction. So I begin the discussion now. So the first question that I'd like to ask you as the panelist is, what led you to choose the program or an executive MBA? What made you decide that now is the time where you want to pick up a learning for yourself and do an exec management program for yourself? So, Mandar, you can start.
Yeah. So, I think that decision why is the first question. And there's always, after 10 to 12 years of when you cross your career, there a time comes when you think and look back about your career and you plan and how to reach the level which you have been always aspiring for. And that was the time for me when I was planning that how to enhance my skills and how I can reach the CXO level. And if I'm aspiring to do that, then what all changes I need to do in myself. So, and yes, after discussion with my seniors, in fact, my colleagues, my top management team, from there, I came to know that there are few things which I need to learn. There are a few frameworks which I need to learn, and I need to upgrade myself in terms of skills, which I think is the key decision-making point for me. And then I started researching about this particular course and executive MBA courses across India and in fact outside India. And when I came to know about PGP Max, and then I started researching about this particular course, the content when I went through, the kind of professor, the feedback I got from alums, then I was kind of sure that, yes, this is something which I really want for myself. And I was ready to invest on myself, because from everywhere, one input was surely there, that the kind of learning you will get from here. And that was the key thing which I wanted, that I want to broaden my learning canvas. So the breadth of learning canvas can only be broadened if you, and for that you need education, and that too from the best of the colleges, best of the professors, which PGP Maths was providing. So that's the reason why I took this decision, and thankfully it has been one of the best decisions which I have taken for myself. And I would also like to hear from Subbu or Anuj what made them take this decision.
Yeah, Subbu, over to you now. What made you choose a learning path for yourself?
Yeah, one of the key reasons for me is as you spend close to 15 plus years in any organization, you generally start seeing yourself with people who are doing better than you and people who are there, who are climbing up the ladder. So then you can really identify areas where you need to have better framework and better understanding and more windows to think. So that was one of the things which was happening with me. Actually, I was looking for some of the global schools for doing a short-term course or a course where you spend 3 to 6 months and then you get into the action mode after that. But when I actually spoke to a few of the people who have done this course, and also through various modes, since I am in Hyderabad, I keep hearing about ISB, and we know that action around ISB. And I thought ISB would be a good pivot for me to start this process. And I was not sure which program, but then PGP Maths suited rightly, because one is definitely you can manage your work and also the course. That is one key thing. And second most important thing when you do PGP Maths is you need to have great support from family as well. So being in Hyderabad, that is another aspect which was always supporting me. And third important factor is, as Mandar was saying, the continuous education part. Because it's not that you do a course and then you forget it. But if we are aligned with an organization or an institution like ISB, it definitely helps you to keep enhancing the learning canvas. And also you can become much better as you keep having this process of continuous learning. So those were the three key things which drove me towards this decision.
And one key, sorry to interrupt. One key differentiator which all the ISBNs or PGP Maths students were sharing with me when I was researching about this particular course, that not only the learning from the professor, but the peer learning is a key differentiator as compared to the courses available in other schools. So that was something which I thought then I should not miss this opportunity, because the average experience of, in fact, our batch also is around 17 to 19 years. So learning from the peers, from different industry, from different departments, that has been a great experience for me.
Sure. Thank you, Mandar. Thank you, Subbu. Anuj, your inputs here.
Yeah, I think Mandar and Subramaniam has covered pretty much all the different aspects of it. But I'll take a stab at talking about it from a very different perspective, right? From an MBA perspective, right, it's always a big decision as to when do I do it? Is it the right time from an experience perspective, at the stage perspective? Should I do full-time? Should I do part-time? Should I do executive? Should I do a distance? There are so many choices now that I struggled with it, at least. And I know that when I discussed it with my colleagues, I know each one of them at certain point had the same thought in their mind. And then the next question that came to my mind was, is it really worth it, right? Which is it giving me the value of the return that I'm, or the investment that I'm doing, and will it give me the returns that I want to go and look at? And I'm going to answer that in a couple of different ways so that you guys get the complete perspective. To start with, why I picked executive versus full-time versus any of the other options out there, right? I personally struggled for almost 6 months, which one was the right way to go. I actually did a lot of my own research. I spoke to a lot of the people who were part of ISB and were doing the courses, part of the set of people that I could go and reach out through my extended circle of who had some association with ISB in terms of executive and stuff. And it fundamentally came down to three aspects that I looked at, right? One was, to me, full-time would have been ideal, right? But at the point where I was in my career, I didn't want to go ahead and take a break. I had financial and personal responsibility towards my family, which complicated it, right? Now, within distance, there were multiple options, whether you could go ahead and do it from a senior management course outside of India, within India. And then again, there are a lot of different flavors. The reason I picked ISB over everybody else, one was the strength of the network. They are now 20,000 plus in terms of the number of people that have passed out. And that's a big differentiator to go ahead and take, is because as I plan to go ahead and have my own business at one particular point of time. Just 1 second, guys. My son just walked in and is rolling away to glory. It was something that was really important to me. If I'm going to go into my own business, then I certainly would want to go ahead and leverage the combined capability and capacity that the network can go ahead and offer. And that's a huge, huge differentiator. The second thing, I looked at this heavily, there's a lot of organizations and universities out there who talk a lot about theory. In theory, you can go ahead and find in papers that are published online. Just to go ahead and say that internet is full of data. It's the information that is really important and differentiated, right? So I wanted to ensure that whoever was teaching me is able to go ahead and talk with something that was behind them, which essentially in education field is research, right? A big, big differentiator, ISB probably in Indian context and global context, is one of the few universities setups that go ahead and have professor who do exceptionally high amount of research. And when we talk to the professor, you can clearly realize they would be talking about their market research that they have done, how they have published studies and the comparatives that they have done over a period of time. So that was the second big reason for me. And third, which essentially translated into, right, the brand name. I think when you go ahead and look at Asian subcontinent, there is no other competition out there in terms of the brand name that ISB carries, even especially in the context of the courses we are talking about. They are globally recognized, and they are standards that they are competing not with the Indian universities or Indian colleges. They are competing at the global field in each and every course that they go ahead and offer. So for me, it by the time I was done with my research, it came out to be, hey, who else is standing in the field other than ISB? That's one part. The second part, which I spoke about in the beginning, was the whole return on investment piece. And quite honestly, that that was a debate that I had with my family. But again, I tried to go and break it down into some things that I could go ahead and put my hands around. And it all came down to that the returns you go ahead and get from an organization like ISB comes not just in form of what you get immediately, but in long term. And I can say for sure that I was wrong when I started off this whole process, because I grossly underestimated what I'll go ahead and get out of it, because what I'm almost at the far end of my course and almost about to go and pass out. So I know that I've gained much more of value than anything else that I originally perceived it to be. So it's, I think, if it's executive MBA, if it's MBA, the question should not be why, but why not, and why not with ISB, which is the best.
Thank you, Anup. That was so wonderfully explained, and you know, it must have answered a lot of queries in our you know, attendees' minds also. So going ahead with the next question, what is the advice that you'd like to give to the future aspirants who are applying for the PGP Max program? You know, looking back at your experiences, your class and the situation that you were in, what is the advice that you would give to them? So Mandar, you know.
Yeah, so there is one piece of advice which I would like to share, and that is, since you are investing so much on yourself, come with an open mind. So what I mean is, let your experience be your asset and not liability. And what happens is, sometimes we have experience of 12 to 15, 20 years in a certain role, and that sometimes becomes a baggage when you come with that particular experience. So don't let that become your baggage, but let that become your asset. And that will certainly help you in terms of learning, because the batch mix you should be rest assured that the batch mix will be good. People will come from different industry, from different roles. It can be from finance, logistics, industries like IT, pharma, aviation, any industry. The whole mix will be certainly good. That ISB ensures that the mix of the batch is always. It was not only for our batch, but I've gone through the mix of the previous batches also. And in fact, the August batch also, the batch mix is really will definitely be a very good mix. So the learning you get from them will certainly help you to understand the things which professor teaches you. Because there are certain things, sometimes during the session, the classroom sessions, you will not understand because it is not your area of expertise. But after the classroom session, when the other session starts with your peers and your batchmates, when you have group discussions or you study together, and whatever you are trying to learn, it is part of their current role in their current organization. So the way they teach you those things, let it be finance or logistics or marketing. So that time, if you don't have open mind, then it certainly becomes difficult to understand the concepts, understand the challenges, understand how a certain framework or certain way of working can impact the decisions. And one thing about this course is it works on your thought process, and which helps you in decision making. And that I have personally experienced after ISB. It has certainly helped me in decision making. And right now, in terms of ROI, what Anuj has shared, it is always relative. Yes, because everybody joins this course with certain aspirations, and ROI means different for different person. If there is a yes or no answer for our ROI, I will say, yes, I got my ROI. But what it certainly will do, it will certainly put you on a right path where you will get the acceleration which you have been aspiring in your career. So that is a piece of advice from my side to all the aspiring students, that come with an open mind. It is as simple as that.
Thank you, Mandar. Thank you for putting it up. And, you know, Subbu, what advice would you give to the attendees today?
I think a very valid point which Mandar had said, and just to take on that point and add further, I think one of the key thing which I experienced when I came up in the initial terms of the course is, I think unlearning is very, very difficult task. You can learn a lot of things, but I think across, once you do 15, 16 years in your career, that learning and then unlearning and then the relearning starts. So that unlearning part is something which we have to gear ourselves because we don't know, because we know how to learn. There is no framework of unlearning which has been there in any of our education system. So that is something which will drain a lot of energy out. And this course is definitely a roller coaster course. So it takes you from, it will take you to a big high one day, and the next day you will not find, you will be in no man's land. So that process of unlearning is very important. Then I think the learning part will happen automatically, because we are all tuned towards learning. So in that way, it will happen in a natural course. And second most important thing, which I think both Anuj and Mandar touched upon, is on the peer learning and people around. So I think that is another validation which you get when you pick this course. You may still have doubts, but when you see your peers, there will be people who are at the CEO level, who are in multinational organization handling cross-regional functions, and also people from IAS, people who have worked in companies which are run by public sector organizations. So there are so many stereotypes which get broken when you actually see your peers. And that is another part of the experience which will always add to that. And most important thing is we need to have some kind of a purpose or a goal why we want to really go for this course. I think that is something which will derive the ROI and also the validate your decision of why going for this course. So these are few pieces of advice I would give people who want to go for this.
Thank you, Subbu. Anuj, your thoughts on this?
Yeah, I completely agree on the relearning part, which Mandan and Subramanian touched upon. I think there are a couple of things that this course definitely goes ahead and promise you. I can go ahead and let you know that you will struggle. You will have sleepless nights. You will have, in your dreams also, you'll be figuring out answers to this problems that you are dealing with in ISB, and then at some point during your course of your education. So it's not something, if you feel that you will be able to juggle this and do your daytime work on the side during the duration of the course, forget about this. Don't even try to go and come to this course. That's not that easy. Can you do one odd call? Maybe. But there is a lot of stuff that you will be learning. And if you want to go ahead and extract a value out of this, you really want to go after every discussion that you have with your peer. Ensure that you understand what people are talking about, and which will, by the way, will be tons of stuff for you to read. There are case studies, there are supporting documents. I think in my entire life, I've not read so much material. And clearly, Mandar is laughing. He's my colleague from my ISB batch. He knows we were overwhelmed with the quality and the quantity of material we received. And some of the loss that you see on my hair is probably because of ISB. But the other part of it is, it's been fun, guys.
Don't scare them off, Anuj. We are here to motivate.
No, but it's been fun, right? It feels amazing on going back to your studies and realizing that you can still be surprised by the fun that you have when you're learning new stuff, and you get so excited, like a childlike curiosity, and hey, this is even possible. And you're not just doing theoretical stuff, right? There are simulations where you're actually making decisions on the mark in an environment which replicates real-time environment, where you're competing with your colleagues who are equally focused and driven to go ahead and perform. And there's so much of learning comes out of that. I just can't go ahead and tell you. And for the people who have been away from college for a long time and have not done anything, this is just a wonderful experience that I kept telling everybody in my circle that they need to go ahead and do it. Just for the ROI it gives, but also for the fun it gives you. So, different perspective.
Yeah. Thank you, Anil. Thank you for that lovely answer. So, you know, we have a lot of people who have joined here and who are working on their applications for the program, and they wanted to hear from you. So what you know, advice would you give to them while they are filling up their application for the program? And, you know, any guidance that you would like, or any points that you'd like to share to them on building a strong application. So, you know, probably Anuj, you can start this time.
So there are two fundamental things you need to go ahead and remember about this, right? When you're doing it, one, be honest and transparent. The more you go ahead and reflect what you're really doing, right, the better people in ISB will get to know you, and they will be able to go and pair you with the right group that is coming in, right? And it's important that you, because this is a group learning, it's not a classroom based session where you are just getting downloads. So it is like really what Mandar and Subramanian have been talking about. It is a colleague, a set of people coming together and learning, not just from the class, but outside with each other. So it's really important that you are transparent and honest with yourself on what you are, what you're going into, and what is the reason why you're going out there. B, don't do it at the last minute. This is not something you can do in 24 hours. I think from the time I took the decision and I started working on my application, it took me almost about a month. And people might say, really, that's long, but it is a lot of effort. You have to go ahead and do, I'm not sure if you still have essays, and you still have to go and get reference letters, which I believe is the case. But that's something which will take time, which will take commitment even before you're hitting it. And the whole process and experience of going through this program and applying for it will really give you a view of really how it is when you apply for a global MBA also. So the standards are exactly the same. So don't do this in a rush. You'll do injustice to yourself.
And adding to this, I would like to say that try to tell everything about yourself. Use those essays for that, because during you are going to definitely share about your work experiences and achievements in your works, but use those essays to tell about yourself, your creative part, your innovative part, everything about yourself. So that's what Anuj said, that it takes time, and don't go for last minute filling of application, because then you will certainly miss the chance. Because a person who is going to read the application, he is going to read you through that application, and he is going to shortlist you through that application. So take this application seriously, and be, as Anuj said, be completely honest about yourself. That will certainly help you.
Thank you, Mandar. Subbu, your views on the application?
Yeah. I have two very interesting experiences when I did my application. Definitely, first thing is my request to everybody who is applying is not to look this as a job application or something like that. It's more about how you reflect yourself, and when you write on that, it definitely adds to various perspectives which you would not have thought that you are able to do. So that is one. And second interesting part which happened with me was you had to get your application acknowledged by your boss. So that is when actually like even you won't believe that your boss is so good, and he's keen on your learning, and there is a different kind of discussion which starts, and suddenly you feel that you both are actually becoming better colleagues. So that is another aspect which I think will add a lot of dimension to the boss colleague relationship in the organization, which I experienced personally, and I could see that suddenly the impression of somebody who was behaving with you differently changes completely when he really feels, okay, he is somebody who is investing in himself, he is trying to do things which may be good for him, and we can extract that for the organizational benefit. So that brings a new dimension, and like definitely it's not a one day application filling process. It takes, I don't know, Anuj would have dwelt in more in detail, 1 month is I feel long time, but definitely it takes more than a week, 10 days time to get things together and all the documents needed, and I'm sure admission team will be chasing people for, like how people were chasing with me. It is worth spending that time and making it properly rather than rushing it up in the last minute.
Yeah, good point, Subbu. The thing is that this one advice is really good, that do interact with your either colleagues or boss or someone from top management who you think can really guide you on filling this application, who has gone through such kind of course, do interact with them. They will definitely give you a good input, and also your relation with them will improve for sure. So because you are valuing their education, their learning, so definitely they will take a step forward to help you out, and it will definitely help you in filling this application.
Yeah, I'll add one more thing. Sorry, Smriti. It's the second time I'm interrupting you. But while you're doing this, right, spend time with your family too. They will sacrifice hugely when you'll be in this course. They'll have to manage without you. And believe me, I have personally had a challenge that I had my kid born the same week I did my first term. So it took a lot for my wife to go ahead and manage without me. But I still would not change anything in a heartbeat, because it does go ahead and give you the return on what you're looking for.
Thank you, all of you, for the lovely suggestions. And yes, we are chasing the applicants to make them fill a good application. Thank you, Subha, for pointing that out. So, audience, we are opening the session for Q&A, and I have already received a few questions now, which I'll be picking up. And, please feel free to write any queries you have from the panelists today. So, first question we have from Koteshwar. He is asking, have you started understanding business issues or matters differently than you understood before PGP Max program? Is one of his questions. So Anuj and Mandar, since you are more into the program than.
So yes, the answer is yes. And how I would say, because before this program, whenever you were taking any decisions or you're working on a task, you had a restricted mindset. Because you only had experience of your own role. You were not understanding the challenges. For me, it happened. I was not understanding the challenges and responsibilities of my cross-functional teams. So post this program, because this program also helps in people management and how to ensure the whole team works for you and not only works with you. So when you go with that approach, definitely the decision-making improves, which has happened for me. And this ISB course will definitely help you in doing this, because it is not only the courses like finance management or accounts course or logistics or statistics. The courses we have a course where we are taught how to handle different teams, how to interact with cross-functional teams, how to handle different situations, how to handle crisis situations. So once you undergo those, and it was kind of a simulation kind of study. So once you go through such kind of experience, and once you come back to your job experience and you come back to your work, definitely your way of working changes. The way you start interacting with your colleagues, with cross-function team members, it definitely changes, and it changes for good, because then you also start valuing their challenges and why, if there is an argument, why they are not agreeing to a point. And then collectively a collaborative approach starts, and definitely a better decision comes out of that particular discussion. So this has been a learning for me, and this is the way this course has helped me and is helping me in my work.
Anuj, your views?
So in terms of the answer, right, this does things at multiple levels. One is what Mandar spoke about. Absolutely. He'll help you frame the problem correctly. Not just, again, most of us, when we think, and which Mandar really connected on, right, is the part that we frame the problem from our perspective versus defining it as the business problem, which is aligned with the vision or which is aligned with the objective that you're driving towards for whatever activity where this business thought process is required. And then you are solving it with a possible set of solutions versus just looking at the problem and hoping somebody else solves it, or putting it across with the right justifications, linking it with the objectives, driving solutions, and taking the ownership, right, is all connected back to what you will go ahead and learn in the course. There's going to be situations you'll never get the answers to even in ISB, right? They will not give you all the answers, but it'll give you the abilities to go ahead and go after in the right direction and have a roadmap on how to go ahead and implement it.
Yeah, building that roadmap definitely is something will happen post because the frameworks which are taught and the way we have been interacting during our group discussions and a common objective, all of us together, and believe me, even we had heated arguments during our group discussions because everybody has his or her own experience of 15 to 17 years in a role they have worked, and they have been a good performer in that particular role. So after handling such situations, when then you realize that it is not your own objective, it is something related to the business, and collaboration is something which is definitely required if you need to go up in the ladder. So this is what ISB has taught. And one thing is there, especially during this COVID times, many of you must have experienced that all of us are going through, all our organizations are going through some certain kind of change. So managing this change in a better way is what definitely this course will help you, because there are many change management exercises which you will go through in this particular course. And this is something in all the organization across the industries, change management is something which you cannot avoid, because changes happens for good, and managing people and convincing your team or your colleagues for that particular change is sometimes becomes, convincing yourself becomes also a challenge. But when you have this open mindset, because the thought process completely changes after this particular course, you definitely deal with this change management in a very better way. So this is how it has helped me in my work life.
Thank you.
Yeah, just to add what Mandar mentioned. Sorry, Smriti. I'll just give a real life example, because when we started the course, 2019 August, we started, and we hit the COVID in March. So then there was a lockdown. So as an somebody who started the course in between, and in our organization, it's very difficult to push through certain things because there are certain ways in which the organization works. But COVID changed everything, and everybody would have seen how FMCG companies operated and how they ramped up things. So in my case, a personal example was I could convince maximum investments because of the frameworks which we got from the course. And you can really pinpoint on issues, and you can really convince the finance team, the R&D team, and the manufacturing team to take up certain decisions, which will help you to actually push through things much quickly, rather than just pushing it from a sales and marketing point of view. Because it's always seen that, okay, it's your hidden agenda which is running. But when you talk their language, and when you bring in that holistic approach, so that is what will push the decisions through across the organization, and life of a CEO becomes much easier when there is alignment team below him. So he has to just sign off. So That way I have experienced that multiple times during this last 7-8 months.
The win-win approach.
Yes.
Thank you so much. And so the next question is again from Koteshwar Rao. He's asking, were you able to solve any issues differently or more efficiently, or unable to solve previously in your current organization? So what difference did it make in resolving your issues or conflicts?
The example which I took is a case like earlier, for example, if I had to go for any investment proposal, like because like everybody would have seen, like for example, the sanitizer. How many of us use sanitizer before COVID hit us? Very few who would be traveling, who are more frequently visiting multiple people. Those are the guys. But when actually this hit and people are looking for a solution, but industries are closed, nobody is there to coordinate, but still there are certain decisions which had to be taken and we had to go for certain actions from, it's the entire supply chain which has to align, which would not have happened, especially in my point of view. I would have told, okay, there is a demand in the market, why don't we launch a product? That's where it would have ended. But going back and understanding and tying up all the related aspects, that is a key decision which helped me during the framework which has come from the course. Like I can easily say what is a return on investment for this investment. I can say what is the NAV will be there. So those are the terms which any finance guy will be allowed to hear from any marketing guy, because marketing, they see that people who go and just reduce the price and sell the product. Whereas I can talk to a supply chain guy and say, these are the aspects which I am tying up. Why don't you speak to this guy? And all these happening remotely. So this is an example of how things can change when you have a wider perspective. You have multiple windows which open, which definitely helps you to think through that and find a holistic solution for any given problem.
Yeah, Manal, you were saying something.
No, the same thing I was saying, that Subbu has shared one example, which definitely proves the point. And after the course, because our batch is kind of a COVID times batch, so there were many things which I was sharing that we had to change in our way of working post that. And like in most of our sessions, or finance sessions or marketing sessions, there were examples, like I'm from automobile industry, tractor industry. So in this, I have learned during the course that economies of scale matter and how certain decisions can be taken, which is going to help you in terms of profits. And those kind of decisions were taken because manufacturing was a challenge during COVID period. Transportation was the biggest challenge. And we took that as an opportunity, and which for long term is now helping us. Like we were only transporting using trucks or by road transportation used to happen. But during the COVID, most of the transportation started through trains, which was usually 1% only. And from manufacturing plant we have in Madurai and Bangalore, from there across India, we were using trains to transport tractors, because during lockdown period, it was not possible through roads. So and now when we look back, for long term, we have started planning in advance, forecasting in advance, and the accuracy of forecast is also improving. And we are doing that so that we can transport in big numbers using train, which is definitely going to help us in our profitability for long term. So such kind of ideas comes out only when you have learned certain frameworks, you have gone through certain case studies of similar examples, similar industries. And definitely it has helped me because in my particular role, it was the biggest differentiator that time, because wherever the stock was available, only there the sales was there, because demand was for all the industry, the demand was the same. But the availability of the stock was the biggest challenge. And this particular idea has really helped the organization and is going to be a long-term decision for us now. So this is just one example I would like to share, but there are many such examples, which I would say now we don't even remember, because it has changed the way of working, our thought process. So the win-win approach is one thing I would say, which is now all of us, what Anuj has also shared, what Subha has also shared, that it is not only my role, my responsibility, my target I'm looking at. I'm going for the holistic approach. And when you go with that kind of approach to any department, any cross-function or to your channel, your distribution channel, definitely the decisions you take are much, much better and the buy-in is much better, which is definitely going to help you in long term.
Yeah. Thank you, Mandar. Yeah, Anuj, you have any points to answer?
No, I'm just going to go ahead and highlight a raw piece Subramanian talk about, right? I think that's a big differentiator, is the fact that we can talk the language of every other department within the organization. I think when you talk in their language with the same data sets and have a collaborative approach, I think it really works out. We have hundreds of examples, I'm sure, that we can go and share in from a day-to-day life perspective. And I think a couple of big life-changing decisions Subramanyam and Mandar have already spoken about. But you will not even, once you, by the time you're done with these frameworks, right, you will not even realize that they are a different framework that you have absorbed before you were went into the course, because it becomes second nature to you. And by, when you're doing things, it just comes to you naturally. Just wanted to go ahead and highlight that point.
Thank you, Anuj. And we have a next question for you only, Anuj. So Rajiv is asking, I expect a lot of effort we need to give for this course, but does this support continue jobs along with this course?
So we've, as long as you're setting the expectations correctly with your leadership, I think, and your family, they are two important stakeholders that you need to go ahead and really take care of. This is not a short course, right? It's 15 months, which is almost 1.5 years of your life. And not just the time that you spend on the campus, but outside when you're doing your assignments, you're preparing for your case studies, all that will eat up your time. So you definitely want to go ahead and have your buy-in and be mentally ready that you will be sacrificing some part of your fun, some part of the activities that you used to do on the side with your family, friends, which you would not be able to go ahead and do. But at the same time, it's a journey that will go ahead and reward you repeatedly. Because every time you go through a term, right, you learn that it's like a jigsaw puzzle, right? You start seeing things come together more holistically and more completely as you go along the course. So yeah, that's my view. Maybe Subramanyam, you want to add something or Mandar?
Well, it's rightly shared by Anuj that you need to align your management before joining this course. And because it takes, it's a not a short course, as he said. And definitely you're not joining this course alone. You're joining this course with your family because they have to sacrifice a lot. And yes, it is time consuming. The assignments takes time. The classes takes time. Not only the classroom sessions, you have to prepare for the next term classes during your working hours. So it is a time consuming process, but one thing is there, you will definitely learn time management after PGP Max. And because that is something, that is the biggest learning, I would say. After the first 2 to 3 terms, you will be a better manager for sure. Because once you learn time management, you can manage anything in life. So you can manage time for your family, for your work, for your colleagues, for everyone post this particular course. And it is just the first 2-3 terms, you will find it a bit difficult, I would say. But then the whole ecosystem around you definitely accepts the fact that you are going to cut off for a while. And you will also accept that you need to cut off. Otherwise, the learnings will get hampered. So before joining the course, you will have to align your family and your top management. Then it will not be an issue at all once you join here. So do have a proper discussion with your bosses and the management before joining the course, because they will certainly understand that it takes time to do this executive MBA course, and the assignments, the case studies are definitely time consuming.
Sure. Thank you, Mandar. So Subbu, we have a question for you specifically. You said that ISB community has 20,000 plus alumni, but many colleges outside India, they have a bigger and better connected number of alums. So why do you think ISB has an edge over them, other than it being convenient for you, being in Hyderabad to pursue this course?
Like, one of the thing is definitely the numbers will be bigger for other college, but what is the quality of the numbers and what is the engagement level? So those two things will definitely matter. Again, like I don't want to talk just in air, but we recently did a leadership summit, which was again during COVID times, and it connected across last 20 years of like in PGP Max, maybe last 10 years of PGP Max alums. And now you can just, they are just a call away. It is not that, and I was part of the organizing team, and we know who's the guy whom I should go when I need to connect, or who is the guy whom I should interact with. And what I also found is the alumni activity which is happening from ISB is far better than even IIMs, because there is some lag which IIMs have, but ISB definitely does much better alumni engagement, and the action around alumni will engage yourself. And most importantly, you should be ready to engage. Like if you are aloof and you don't want to just be part of the activities which are happening, then you won't gain from what is there. But if you are somebody who is looking to network, who is ready to go to that extra mile, and networking is all about giving that sufficient time and extending your arm also. So if you do that, I'm sure that it's going to help you in the long run.
Thank you, Subhu.
Yeah. I would like to add some piece to it, right? I think there is enough colleges outside of India which have bigger alumni. Whoever said this is absolutely right. But it's also the context that is important, right? In today's world, the ISB context is primarily India. And the growth story of India is being written as we are part of it. The question is, the alumni outside of India will not really understand the context or the growth story that is yet to come. But the people out here can. And when you see the multiplying effect, when you reach out to these guys, right, you immediately get a response. They are always willing to go ahead and help out. You quickly realize that the same thing cannot be done from another country, right? Secondly, the journey of ISB and the alumni and the engagement, in fact, does not really stop after you are done with your college. I think they have been really active in terms of holding sessions, conducting speaking seminars, having panelist discussions with a broader set of people on different topics, from leadership to industry specific event driven stuff, which can really help you with the information and the data you need for your roles in your day to day life, even beyond what you're learning in the regular ISB PGP Max course. So it's very holistic and very wide spanning than just limiting it to the alumni.
Sure. Thank you, Anuj. So Jyoti is asking, you know, all of you, how has your international immersion experience been? So any of you, if you want to take a shot at it.
We had the opportunity, luckily, that it was before the COVID time. So we went to CIPS China, and it was a different experience altogether, because I would say the classroom sessions or the kind of professor quality, it's the same, because it is not that, because here also we get the best of the professor from across the globe. And for whatever means for economics, we have a different professor, and we have best of the professors available in ISB. It's the experience about understanding that particular country and the global market. That is something different, which I would say, for me, understanding China, Chinese market, and the challenges of for different organizations operating in those particular market, and how China as a country which has grown in this last 10 to 15 years, understanding that particular dynamics. So that was something key learning for me. And I think Anuj, you have done this online Wharton course as well. So he will be able to share, because that is something which I'm still waiting to do. The classroom session, so which are yet to happen. So Anuj would like to share about Wharton course content.
Yeah, the beauty about that is, quite honestly, while I at this point we didn't get the classroom experience sitting at Wharton, which I know is something I'm missing, at least for the time, because we will be going there. Instead of doing it one go, we are doing it in two splits for the people who are interested in doing it online. But I think from a professor, the quality of delivery, the quality of information that shared, I think there's never a compromise. Yeah. I'm not going to go and say that it is not a challenge at a personal level, because it takes time to orient yourself when you're doing online courses over Zoom versus when you're doing in class. But once you have that orientation changes within you and that you are able to adjust, I think you can cope it up. But I would, that's not my preferred mode. And that's not what I would, what is the differentiator for ISB, because that I think is available. The reason I did this is online one was because I wanted to go in and engage with the professors early. And I have some commitments that I know are something that I can't get away as we go into the future. My organization is evolving at a very fast pace because of the whole COVID-19 pressures that have come across. And I was not sure things would remain the same in the future, and I wanted to be ready for it. So that's one of the reasons why I did it. But I think the immersion is also one of the differentiators that you would go ahead and find versus the other colleges. It gives you the perspective of being at the location, looking at some things very, very different, and why they have been successful for those locations versus just doing it over a exercise. And plus, it's a great opportunity to create memories and partnerships with your batch, because believe me, as simple as we getting on the wrong train and going in the wrong direction 2 hours was a great experience, because we were all together as a group and had so much to go and share once we are back and sharing a bottle of beer at the end of the day.
Sure. Thank you, Anuj. So now Mrityunjay is asking a few questions. So he wants to know at what level of role and responsibilities or experience will be the PGP Max course most relevant? And will it also be relevant to people who are specifically working in the IT industry at an architect level? So any specific answer you would like to give to Mrityunjay?
Let me take a stab at it, since I'm from the same industry segment that you're asking the question for. So let me try and break this down, right? Is this course for everybody? No. If you are only interested in being on the technical side and just focus on the architecture and be an individual contributor, maybe not. And it's, by the way, I'm not criticizing it. I'm in fact saying that it's definitely not really for individual contributor kind of a profile, if that's what your focus is even for the future. But if you are looking to go ahead and be in the leadership, whether it's at a manager, senior manager, or creating your own organization, like doing a startup or something like that, definitely the course is for you. The advantages is I think have already been spoken about quite a little bit, so I'm not touching upon the ones that we have already spoken about. But the pieces that it gives you, right, while we have talked about the hard pieces, there is a softer piece which I don't think anybody spoke about yet, is the fact that what confidence you feel knowing that you are not just walking into a room with the knowledge that you acquired doing things, but you have capability of acquired knowledge out of your domain, going out there and understanding different perspective from batchmates. It just gives you that inner self help that you need, that it is okay. And you learn this when you were a part of these courses, right? Even CEOs don't get every decision right. And that course, right, when I had, I think in my heart, I already knew it. But when you see it with data points, you see it with case study that somebody has performed, it just lets you know it's okay to be wrong. It's, in fact, it's better that we fail and learn from it then think that we are perfect. And that goes a huge long way. In terms of IT professionals, there is essentially no difference across whether you're an IT professional or whether you are from any other industry, right? Because this is a mixture, you learn everything about every industry and you certainly want to go ahead and use the rich experience. Don't, if you're going to bottle yourself into just thinking about your organization, your context, then you will not open to what is happening in the world. One famous case that we had studied, and if you guys get a chance, look at Amazon buying the whole food organization in US, right? This is Amazon, which is traditionally an online store, buying a high marketplace grocery store, physical locations in posh areas. And that, when we did a deep dive, right, the retail stores were completely caught off guard and they were blindsided by this whole Amazon stepping in, and their share market, share prices, which is a reflection on whether they are ready. And it's a market fundamental that we go ahead and use to judge how good the organization's decision market, decision making is. Their shares dropped drastically and Amazon's prices, share prices went up. So you learn to read what others are seeing in the market, and you realize that you have something which you didn't have before you started on this journey.
So there's a follow-up question on this, that, you know, will PGP Max help me move to management roles if I'm, you know, a fully technical person? As of
I can answer this in two parts, right? There is one thing is the capability, which is that you will get all the toolkit, the tool set, the frameworks, the models, and it'll make you competent enough that you can position yourself and do all the right things. What it will not do is do it for you. There is no substitute to hard work and doing the groundwork, right? If you have the tools in your toolkit and you decide not to use it, instead of a screwdriver, you try to use a hammer, you'll get some result, but don't blame ISB for it, right? It's because you're using the wrong toolkit. And if you use the right tool, you frame it the right way, there is no stop to it. And I can assure you with confidence, right, that what you learn in ISB, what you learn in IIM, what you learn in Wharton are fundamentally the same. It's the quality of professors is also, at least I can confidently say with Wharton and some of these best colleges, ISB is definitely out there. And these guys will go ahead and make you, force you to go ahead and reinvent yourself during the course. Again, but at the end of the day, it will come to how much you leverage out of it.
Thank you, Anuj. So next question is again from Jyoti. She is asking, how about getting new opportunities apart from the existing organization's roles? And anyone you know, from your batch could switch to better positions during the course?
Yes. See, this course will definitely give you the platform, because platform to network outside the organization also, because the alumni of ISB are placed in best of the position, in best of the organizations. Some have their own startups, some have their own businesses. So, and you are definitely, you, ISB is going to give you that platform to connect with them all. So again, it depends on your networking skills, how you can leverage from that. And coming to your own organization, you can definitely, the interaction with your top management, with your bosses, the kind of interaction you were having earlier, and the kind of interaction you will have post the course will definitely change. And do not come with the expectation, and I'm telling you again that do not come with the expectation that after the course, suddenly, it is not the normal MBA course. that after the course there will be a placement, companies will come and place you and you will get into a new role. It will certainly accelerate your career. Whatever you're aspiring to reach in 10 to 15 years, maybe it will bring it down to 4 to 5 years. That has happened for me. And that will definitely happen if you'll come with an open mind and understand each and every concept. And ISB will definitely give you all that learning and it will definitely give you a platform to network. If both of these things, you will use it properly, you will definitely leverage from it in a better way.
Just to add what Mandar had said, so in our batch, which is a batch which is still, we are yet to complete the course and it's going on, we have an army colonel who has started a startup and it's featured in Forbes. So that is the kind of transformation which it can happen. And like there are people who actually have moved up the ladder. Like it is like you can credit the course and also the frameworks and the thought process change which would have happened. So it is combination of what you take and what you gain both.
I think it's also another piece. Sorry, I'm adding one more thing, Smriti, before we move on. That you know, there's something called signaling also, right? Which means that when you make a commitment to a course like this, it signals to your leadership that you have arrived in your own mind that you're ready for the next role also. And it is, people then immediately realize that we have been underestimating this person. And I'm not saying in every case, right? In some cases, they have realized that they have been sidelining somebody or they underestimated somebody or they suddenly come into the visibility of the leadership, right? Because you're getting the buy-in before you even go into the course. So you will now be on the radar of the CEO. Hey, this guy even is willing to make investment in himself because he believes in so much. They will be willing to give you opportunity out there. How much you make out those opportunities to result in tangible benefits is all up to you, right? But it will open the doors that you never had before. Second thing, I can say it at least, our year was unusual. We had two batches, but usually you would have one. But in our class, in our batch, we had 30 odd people. Out of that, I think about 5-6 of them got hard promotions during the course. Now, I'm not going to be able to go ahead and differentiate and saying that it was, or they already deserved it before and they got it during the ISB or they got it because of ISB. But I can tell you that they got it during our tenure on the class. And this is beyond the projects that people have. Exactly, Mandar is one great example. And by the way, if you guys don't know, he is within TAFE, he manages the most profitable, the biggest center from a state revenue perspective for TAFE out there. So it just goes to show that you can open all the doors that you want with doing this course.
Thank you, Anuj. So we have a question from Murli. He's asking, does this course enable one to take up higher responsibilities and roll up in the hierarchy chain in the organization? If so, what's your experience and can it be quantified to give feel for value add to the participants?
I think I've answered this partially, but I'll go ahead and answer it differently for you. No, it doesn't do anything for you. You have to do the same, right? You have to go ahead and prove that you can go ahead and leverage all the stuff that you go ahead and learn. It suddenly, because you have done a course, nobody will come on the platter and say, hey, now you are the king, please go ahead and take it from us. But what they'll do is, like I said, open the door for you. And if you leverage the right tools, you deliver the right results. Because without results, even your best friend will not go ahead and do anything for you. But if you're able to go ahead and deliver the results and you're willing to go and show the right attitude, right? That, by the way, goes a long way. Even if you don't get the results, it certainly can go ahead and open the doors and open the meet the expectations that you're looking at.
Definitely. And the point which Anu shared earlier that suddenly you will start realizing that people will start valuing you more, your suggestions more. People from different team, business leaders will start calling you for certain inputs for certain long-term decisions. So these kind of changes, you, because of, definitely because of the ISB brand, because they start valuing your inputs and the kind of interaction, the kind of relations you have post that with them will definitely give you a boost in your career. This has definitely happened for me. And this is something we cannot quantify in numbers or something, or how it happened, how ISB, but ISB will provide all the tools, all the platforms, and it is you, as Anuj said, it is you who has to then use it to leverage from it.
Thank you, Mandar. So we have another question from Sumit. Is he's asking, how does the alum and college network help you during the program or once the course is over?
So, again, don't expect the alums to go ahead and help you with the course material or with the case studies, right? ISB has the highest standard of ethics in terms of ensuring that we are delivering the content which we have created. Whether it's flawed, whether it's good, they will talk about all the stuff in details, but they have one thing they don't want to compromise is on the integrity of what you're delivering, right? So no help from a course content. Let me put that out of the door. But from a experience or from support perspective, or if you're talking about needing something from somebody in terms of finding a lead into another industry, all can happen. I'll give you a couple of examples just to go and drive in my point. So in Pau, as one of our colleagues needed some help in the industry, in the government organization, right? And we had a couple of contacts from that IAS and these CEOs of public companies, mm-hmm. also part of our course. He was able to connect with that person, who was able to find another person within the industry who knew the person that he wanted, the first person wanted, and was able to connect and put in a word to ensure that he got the presence and he got the discussion done to go ahead and make it happen. And the second example that I would go ahead and talk about, we have these WhatsApp groups or Telegram groups, right? Where if somebody needs help, they put their help needs out there. And then I'm talking about minutes or hours where somebody would go ahead and respond back, hey, do a one-to-one conversation with me and let me see what I can go ahead and help you. I know some contacts or I have some experience out here. I can go ahead and guide you. And believe me, those are invaluable things. And then, of course, you have, while we don't talk about it very often, the professor themselves,
yes.
are really experienced in the studies that they are doing. And they don't, and not just research, right? These guys have, they are sitting on boards with the different companies like Hero, Honda, some big companies in petroleum. And these are the ones that I know off, on top of my head. They're almost all of them are part of some of the boards. So they can talk from that experience perspective.
Yeah.
And if you reach out to them with the right context, right issue, they can even guide you to somebody who can go in and help you. And believe me, last but not the least, if you have the right idea and you can protect it with patents and stuff, they can help you get financing from ISB itself. ISB does these centers where you innovation centers, which can go ahead and help
D-Lab.
Help the budding companies grow to a point where they can be launched in the market and they can self-sustain themselves. So all that is possible. It's just that how much of it you can go ahead and leverage with the right approach, right? Again, there is no substitute for the quality or what you bring to the table.
And adding to Anuj's last point, if you have an idea of a startup or business which you have been thinking for long, that I want to quit job and I want to start something of my own, and if if you'll connect with the professors, any subject professor, they are definitely going to help you out in that. They will prepare, they'll help you in preparing a business model. And it is not a part of course, I would say. It is unofficially also, I have seen from my batch, people have connected with the professors and the way professors have guided them, because of which my colleagues have taken decisions and opened some startups, which now is actually doing good. So such kind of help you will definitely get. And if you want to connect with the alums and you want any kind of help, that ISBN jazba, I would say, is always there. Because whenever you connect with any alum and you say that you are ISB student, you are from this particular batch and all, they come out, let it be from any industry, let them be at any position, they definitely take a step forward to help you out in whatever form they can. So that help will be definitely there for each one of you.
Thank you, Mandar. Thank you, Anand, for this question. So before we end this session, one last question that one of the participants had is, do you have any examples where people have transitioned from one role to a different role in the same organization while doing the program?
I will give my own example. I was handling a market. I was earlier, during the course, when I joined this particular course, I was handling a region which was where we were not a very big player, or my contribution was not much. And in terms of turnover contribution to the company. And during the course, suddenly my interactions with the top management started increasing, with the cross-functional team, with the vertical heads of all the functions, my interactions started increasing. And this certainly has helped me. I won't say that there is a direct help, I would say, but the kind of interaction it gives the opportunity that everybody starts suddenly valuing you. I'm not sure how to put it in words, but the kind of interaction, then it starts, it certainly helps you. And then they start valuing you. And then now I'm positioned in a market. I'm based out of Jodhpur right now. I'm handling Western Rajasthan, which is one of the biggest contributor to my organization. So ISB has definitely helped me in this. And similar examples I have seen in my batch, that people have been promoted to bigger roles and they have been given bigger opportunities. And that is because they were contributing to the organization earlier as well. But because of ISB, PGP Max, their interaction level and the quality of interaction has increased with their own top management. And which certainly helps you but in long term, it will definitely help you, and which has helped many of us in our batch.
While I can't give a hard number to the question that you've asked, and which is what you were looking at, right? Whether it's 10 people or 20% or something like that. It's very difficult to go ahead and quantify that during the duration of the course, right? Because the
benefits... But still, during the course, only 4 or 5 parties on which we had... During the course, 6 months.
Yeah, ago. I'm not denying it.
So we have celebrated 5-6 achievements of our batchmates, and still we are in the course right now. We are about to finish it. But
that's what I was trying to go ahead and get to, right? Don't go ahead and look at within the course as the measurement. The real benefit of what you gain from MBA from a good college comes over the lifetime. You will see that I think for me it's always been the biggest thing is that self-realization and the self-confidence it brought me more than anything else. But even then, even beyond your course duration, right, this is an incremental gain. It's a step movement, right? If your line curve was like this in your career, the traditional life curve, it would have been, this would just push you up by this and take you along the new path. And that path will never stop based on just one course or one thing. There are a lot of other things you'll have to continue doing, but it does give you a leverage. There are people who have moved within the organization vertically. I know of people who have changed industries from alumni and some people who are working on it as we speak, and some people who have moved within the organization to different roles to take up new challenges within the organization. So everything does happen. It's just that I don't have a hard number to go and give you. But anecdotally, I think Mandar and everybody has spoken about it.
One live case in our batch, like which I actually mentioned even earlier, is we have an army colonel. He's a decorated officer. He's not a normal an army personnel. He was in the battlefield and he actually took a sabbatical. He resigned from army and now he has started a startup which is in edtech space. And he has been featured in Forbes top 10 innovative person. So like he doesn't have a IT background or anything like that. So that is the transformation which can happen. And it's not that he has done it on his own. So like, even I have contributed my bit in that. So everybody in our batch have put in their minds to shape the thing up. So, and definitely vertical movement, there are examples, but as Anuj rightly said, it is not to compare with how others are doing, how you are doing. It is about yourself, how you are moving up on your knowledge chain and also how you are extracting the value out.
Thank you, Subbu, for sharing the example. I think the audience here will get motivated from that example. So, it comes to the end of the session now. So, before we end the session, any parting thoughts for our audience today? We can start in any order.
Again, I will share the same thing which I have started with. If you are planning to join, plan to join with an open mind. And again, I'll repeat that let your experience be your asset and not liability, because this again and again, I'm repeating, because this is something which once you join, you will realize that unlearning is very much important than only the learning will be much better. So if you're planning to join, plan to unlearn and then learn. It will definitely help you in this particular course, because you're investing a lot on yourself and you will definitely get good results once you get to learn the right skills from best of the professors and best of the peers, because I'm sure ISB makes sure that the batch and the batch mix is always one of the best. And the peer learning and the learning from professor will definitely help you in your career and in your personal life as well. So,
thank you, Mandar. Anuj, any parting thoughts from you?
Just, I'm not going to pitch ISB anymore. but what I would go ahead and say is that whether you choose ISB or whether you choose not to, do continue to learn. I think there is an amazing growth story that is coming in India. And we know that each one of us needs to participate in that beautiful story that is going to be written in the future. The other thing that I would suggest is live long and prosper. From my side, that's all I have.
Thank you, Anuj. That was a lovely thought, to keep learning. Subbu, from you, any parting thoughts?
Yeah, I think it's going to be an exciting journey. As Anuj rightly said, it need not be ISB or anywhere, but I think most of us would have experienced during the COVID time. Everybody would have at least did a course on Coursera, or at least registered, or would have done something on Simply Learn. There are so many things, and learning always continues, but the structure around the learning and the long-term benefits which you can gain from your peers. And it's a family for life, like it's friends for life. Your peers are going to be there with you all across for next rest of your life. And I have been a beneficiary of the networking with professors. So professor who taught us in the first term, I still send mails on various doubts which I have. I send them the workings. Is it okay? Should I add something else? So that is something which you will not get when you do something on online or like a recorded learning session. So that is something which you can leverage when you are doing a structured program. So my parting thought finally would be get ready, fasten your seat belts, and I think it's going to be a roller coaster ride.
Thank you, Subbu. That was such an encouraging thought here. And thank you for joining us today, Anuj, Mandar, and Subbu, for a lovely session. And I believe that, you know, our audience must have got their answers, which they were looking for. Thank you for joining in today. And I look forward to connecting with you again. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you, Smriti.
Thank you, Smriti.
Lord.
Thank All you, the best, guys.
Thank you, guys.
All Bye. The best, everyone.
So audience, I'm still here. If you have any queries about the program, you can just raise your hands and I'll allow you to talk and you can ask your questions or any queries about the program or application. We're there to answer. Rajiv, I have allowed you to talk. You can unmute yourself and ask your question, please.
Hi, thank you. My question, I know I have checked that PGP Max dossier. Mm-hmm. So I know that this is a executive sponsor program, and that is the main reason there is no direct placement kind of concept from ISB. Correct me if I'm wrong. So still, I am looking, as this is almost 10 years old program, do you have any data that post this program, whether there is any differences in their earning potential of the participants, whether anything they have changed, whether the, and also from the geography wise or industry wise, there is change in that placement? Just looking.
As per the survey that we have got from the economist and the different sources, is there is a 30% increase in the salary after 2 years of completion of the course. So that is one of the stats that we have, but it's very difficult to measure because once the students are out of the campus or the program or they graduate, it's very difficult to keep a track of them and their salaries, right? So, but the surveys shows that it's an increase in 30% in their salaries.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Rajiv. Any more questions, audience, or we'll end the session and if you have any queries about the application or the program, you can write to us at pgpmax@isb.edu and we'll connect with you to answer your queries. Thank you everyone for joining us today. Have a lovely weekend and I look forward to connecting with you again. Thank you so much.